Hi, it's Stacye. How are you? Happy Tuesday. I hope everybody's well. So let's get started. Thank you to everyone who's taken the time to view and or comment on my blogs on silver.com, MySpace, YouTube, and Facebook. Thank you. So let me say thank you to everyone that left a comment, which was Rico, Arthur, Roger, Linesden, Ephraim, Lady Momo, Jamaican Style, and I think it's Ty Wo. Not sure. Sorry if I mispronounced your name. And Jamaican Style, thank you for finally leaving a comment. I appreciate it. Anyway, so let's get started. The last blog was the realistic happy ending. Some great comments. I haven't commented before, so. But today I want to touch on, I'm not sure if I understood Lady Momo's comment/question correctly, but it made me think of a topic, which was when the dynamics change in a relationship. I always find it interesting when I talk to people, and over the years I've heard many men, and sometimes women, say they can't be friends with the opposite sex if they're not in a relationship with them. But here's the thing, you might be missing out on a great friendship, a friendship that truly will enrich your life, because you're caught up in someone's sex or the fact that you're not having a relationship with them. I truly believe that the greatest romances, the greatest love relationships are people that can say, that was my best friend. It's being able to have your friend with you, and also the love part, the sex and all that is the gravy. But what I don't understand is when relationships are over and all of a sudden everybody feels like there needs to be a war, like they can't be friends and it's over. And okay, but here's the thing, if you really were ever in love, if that person was your friend, then they should remain your friend. And just because the dynamics have changed, because you are no longer physically involved or you're living now in separate residence, it doesn't mean that you can't still be friends. It just means that the relationship has changed. And it saddens me, because I'm friends with everybody I ever dated. I mean, even the, you know, little guys I dated in the, not dated, but probably had crushes on in the fifth and sixth grade. I mean, I never understood why we couldn't remain friends, why you can't see each other and be civil. Okay, so someone didn't conduct themselves the way you thought they should. Someone did something that you didn't think was correct. But here's the thing. We are so caught up in believing that life is black and white, and we're very programmed in believing how relationships have to be and how they have to end, that we get more caught up in what we think we're supposed to do than how we genuinely feel. Just like how we end up in these relationships, which I talk about all the time, we fall into relationships. Well, if you can't be friends and it's really just physical, then yeah, you probably are going to part and maybe not have the best things to say about one another, because you didn't get to know each other and appreciate each other and really be in each other's lives. So, I guess today, short blog for me, but my question really is, because I've heard a lot of men say that they can't be friends with women. I have no use to be friends with a woman. Why would I be friends with a woman? But for those of you that watched my blogs, or maybe either you're one of those people that thinks that, or you know someone that thinks that, I would really like to hear why. Because you could genuinely be missing out on a great friendship, a great business relationship. There's so many things you could be missing out on beyond sex. And I think that sometimes we have to stop looking at each other as just that. You know, a real relationship is about the friendship. It is about loving and caring for each other and being there for each other. It's just like that friend that you have that may be of the same sex that you could not see for months, years, or whatever, and you can meet and just be happy for each other, or happy to see each other. Just because a relationship has ended, a romantic relationship has ended, it doesn't mean that you can't still be friends. It just means that the dynamics have changed. And that's a very different thing. I think that we allow our selfishness, You know, we're very selfish with our platonic and our romantic relationships. We, you know, that's mine. We're like little two-year-olds, you know, that's mine, that's my relationship, and that's, you know, it's going to be this way. But, you know, when you have an open mind and an open heart, everything flows much better. And I think the first step is to realize that our relationships and the people in them are not possessions, and it is a privilege. And if we treated our relationships with more respect, more understanding, and more kindness, I think we'd have better relationships. And then we could dissolve romantic relationships and be able to move into great platonic relationships with the person that we love. So I don't know if that was exactly what she was asking, but it was what was on my mind, so I decided I'd share that with you. Anyway, so my question today is to anyone, male or female, are there some relationships that you're missing out on just because you're allowing, I don't know, silliness to get in the way? Are there some friendships that you didn't really cultivate that, you know, may have been a better friendship than a romantic relationship? Ponder that. Dying to hear what you have to say. I hope everyone has an amazing day. I think there's a World Series. No, it was canceled tonight because of the rain. Possibly there's a game tomorrow. So, okay. Go whoever you're rooting for. I'm not keeping up with baseball this year. I apologize. Sorry. Anyway, have an amazing Tuesday. I will see you soon. Love and blessings.